You guys, trust me, I know it's a little bit weird. I'm in a closet, but like, that's the best place I have to record like a basketball video. Like, the audio is probably in a closet, which is weird. But before I start the video, I just wanted to have a reaction of Richard Unicorn's whatever video. I mean, he was right. I didn't really post videos for a while, and I said it in my other video, other than video game videos, and got a little lazy, but now it's time to have a little war, as he had in his video, subscriber war. So don't subscribe to him, subscribe to me, and subscribe to PewDiePie. Hope you guys enjoy the video. Let's get straight into it. Hello guys, and today I'll be talking about Mitch Richmond and how he's underrated. And I'm just gonna point out the fact before we start this video that he's a six-time NBA All-Star, and he's a Rookie of the Year, Rookie All-Team. He made the Hall of Fame. So yeah, he's got some achievements. He also won MVP of the All-Star game one year. But now let's get into his stats, I guess. Let's just say before I start this video, this guy is a absolute monster. He was an absolute scoring machine over his career. And let's just say he's not talked about enough today when people talk about great shooting guards. In his whole career, he averaged 21 points per game, 3.9 rebounds per game, 3.5 assists per game, a 45.5% field goal percentage, which is crazy. That's pretty decent, actually. 38.8%, that's pretty decent 3-point range for a whole career. Free throw percentage, 85%. That's pretty good. Pretty good free throw shooter, too. Solid. 1.2 steals per game on his career. It's pretty good. I mean, and his best season was with Sacramento in 1996 and 1997 season. He averaged 25.9 points per game, 1.5 steals per game, 4.2 assists per game, 3.9 rebounds per game. He had a free throw percentage of 86.1%, which was better than his other one. So was his rebounds, and his assists per game was better than his career overall, and so was his points per game. Just everything was topped in his stats this year than his whole career, because it was his best year, And his 3-point percentage was 42.8%, which is pretty dang good, honestly. That's impressive. Now, 45.4% field goal percentage, that's the only thing that wasn't topped. His career average is 45.5%. I mean, but it's still impressive, That's 0.1%. Come on, guys. He went from teams like the Golden State Warriors in his first three seasons of his career to the Sacramento Kings for like seven seasons or something like that. And he led them in scoring for seven seasons straight, which is absolutely insane, you guys. Yes, I don't have any more statistics. I don't have much more to tell you guys about this guy. But I'm telling you, he's part of that TMC with Chris Mullin and Tim Hardaway. And they were known for fast-paced basketball and ball movement and just everything. That would have been crazy to watch, but I'm just too young to ever experience him. I just have to sit here and watch highlights and look at his stats and stuff. But I'm sure some of you who maybe have watched him play know that he is a great player, great all-time player, and he deserves more talk to be more talked about nowadays, because in my opinion, he's in argument of being better than Reggie Miller. And don't get me wrong, I'm a Pacer fan. Many people argue that Reggie Miller is a top 10 shooting guard of all time. And if you're gonna argue that, you might as well argue Mitch Richmond being one if you're gonna be arguing Reggie Miller, because if you compare their stats, I mean, Mitch Richmond's looking a bit better. Like, I'm a Pacer fan. I watched the Pacers, love them this year. But you know what? I'm just gonna be honest. I don't want to be biased here. Mitch Richmond was a great overall shooter, jump shooter. He's very fast, and he had a pretty decent 3-point range too. Maybe not as good as Reggie Miller, but he was overall a better scorer than Reggie Miller. And yeah, honestly, he deserves way more respect. He didn't get enough respect. Other than the Kings, I'm sure Kings fans know who Mitch Richmond is, but there's a lot of overall NBA fans who don't know who he is, and I just think he deserves more respect.
Alright, that is the end of the video. Subscribe if you're new, hit that like button, and comment down below what video I should make next.